Uzo, Wikipedia article audio. Uzo is a dry anise-flavored aperitif that is widely consumed in Greece, Cyprus, and Lebanon. Its taste is similar to other anise liquors like pastis and sambuca. Other spirits of the region may or may not include anise, arak, rak, and mastika. History. Name. Preparation. Aperitif drink. Cocktails. Appearance. Drinks with a similar flavor. In popular culture. In fiction. In film. In television. In song lyrics. Uzo has its roots in Tsiporo, which is said to have been the work of a group of 14th century monks on Mount Athos. One version of it was flavored with anise. This version eventually came to be called Uzo. Modern Uzo distillation largely took off in the beginning of the 19th century following Greek independence. The first Uzo distillery was founded in Tirnovos in 1856 by Nikolaos Katsaros, giving birth to the famous Uzo Tirnovou. When absinthe fell into disfavor in the early 20th century, Uzo was one of the products whose popularity rose to fill the gap. It was once called a substitute for absinthe without the wormwood. In 1932, Uzo producers developed a method of distillation using copper stills that is now the standard method of production. One of the largest producers of Uzo today is Varvayanis, located in the town of Plomari in the southeast portion of the island of Lesbos, while in the same town Pitsilady, a variety of high-quality ouzo, is also distilled. Ouzo is usually mixed with water, becoming cloudy white, sometimes with a faint blue tinge, and served with ice cubes in a small glass. Ouzo can also be drunk straight from a shot glass. Uzo is often served with a small plate of a variety of appetizers called mezes, usually small fresh fish, fries, olives, and feta cheese. Uzo can be described to have a similar taste to absinthe, which is licorice-like, but smoother. On October 25, 2006, Greece won the right to label Uzo as an exclusively Greek product. The European Union now recognizes Uzo, as well as the Greek drinks Tsiporo and Psikoudia, as products with a protected designation of origin, which prohibits European makers other than Greece and Cyprus from using the name. There is an Uzo Museum in Plomari, Lesvos. The origin of the name Uzo is disputed. A popular derivation is from the Italian Uso Mas Alia for use in Marseille, stamped on selected silkworm cocoons exported from Tirnovos in the 19th century. According to anecdote, this designation came to stand for superior quality, which the spirit distilled as Uzo was thought to possess. During a visit to Thessaly in 1896, the late Professor Alexander Philadelphius delivered to us valuable information on the origins of the word Uzo, which has come to replace the word Tsiporo. According to the professor, Tsiporo gradually became Uzo after the following event. Thessaly exported fine cocoons to Marseilles during the 19th century, and in order to distinguish the product, outgoing crates would be stamped with the words Uso Mas Alia, Italian for, to be used in Marseille. One day, the Ottoman Greek consulate physician, named Anastas Bey, happened to be visiting the town of Tirnovos and was asked to sample the local Tsiporo. Upon tasting the drink, the physician immediately exclaimed, "This is Uso Mas Alia, my friends," referring to its high quality. The term subsequently spread by word of mouth, until Sapporo gradually became known as Uzo. However, the major Greek dictionaries derive it from the Turkish word uzum, grape. Uzo production begins with distillation in copper stills of 96% alcohol by volume rectified spirit. Anise is added, sometimes with other flavorings such as star anise, fennel, mastic, cardamom, coriander, cloves, and cinnamon. The flavoring ingredients are often closely guarded company recipes, and distinguish one uzo from another. The result is a flavored alcoholic solution known as flavored ethyl alcohol, or more commonly as uzo yeast mu alpha gamma iota omicron zeta omicron upsilon in Greek, the term for yeast being used by Greeks metaphorically to denote that it serves as the starting point for uzo production. The uzo yeast is then distilled. After several hours of distillation, a flavored distillate of approximately 80 ABV is produced. The spirit at the beginning of the distillation and end is usually removed to avoid light and heavy alcohols and aromatics. The heads and tails are usually mixed and distilled again. The product of this second distillation can be used to produce a different quality uzo. This technique of double distillation is used by some distillers to differentiate their products. Makers of high-quality 100% from distillation uzo proceed at this stage with water dilution, bringing the uzo to its final ABV. But most producers combine the uzo yeast with less expensive ethyl alcohol flavored with 0.05% natural anethol, before water dilution. Greek law dictates that in this case the uzo yeast cannot be less than 20% of the final product. Sugar may be added before water dilution, which is done mostly with uzo from southern Greece. The final ABV is usually between 37.5 and 50%, the minimum allowed is 37.5%. Uzo production itself does not include fermentation. In modern Greece, uzeries can be found in nearly all cities, towns, and villages. These cafe-like establishments serve uzo with mezze appetizers such as octopus, salad, sardines, calamari, fried zucchini, and clams, among others. It is traditionally slowly sipped together with mezze shared with others over a period of several hours in the early evening. In other countries it is tradition to have uzo in authentic Greek restaurants as an aperitif, served in a shot glass and deeply chilled before the meal is started. No water or ice is added, but the drink is served very cold, enough to make some crystals form in the drink as it is served. Uzo can colloquially be referred to as a particularly strong drink, the cause of this being its sugar content. Sugar delays ethanol absorption in the stomach, and may thus mislead the drinker into thinking that they can drink more as they do not feel tipsy early on. Then the cumulative effect of ethanol appears and the drinker becomes inebriated rather quickly. This is why it is generally considered poor form to drink uzo dry hammer in Greece. The presence of food, especially fats or oils, in the upper digestive system prolongs the absorption of ethanol and ameliorates alcohol intoxication. Uzo is not used in many mainstream cocktail drinks, although in Cyprus it does form the basis of a cocktail called an ouzini. Uzo is a clear liquid. However, when water or ice is added, uzo turns a milky white color. This is because anethol, the essential oil of anise, is completely soluble in alcohol at approximately 38% ABV and above, but not in water. Diluting the spirit causes it to separate, creating an emulsion, whose fine droplets scatter the light. This process is called louching, and is also found while preparing absinthe. Similar aperitifs include ogi, mastika from Bulgaria and Macedonia, rak from Turkey, pastis, and arak. Its aniseed flavor is also similar to the anise-flavored liqueurs of sambuca and anise and the stronger spirits of absinthe. Aguardiente, made from sugar cane, is also similar. The Italian drink Palinai Mistra, named after the Greek city of Mistras in the Peloponnese, is a version of ouzo made in Rome that closely resembles Greek and Cypriot ouzo. The Deportees Club by English musician Elvis Costello. Mudride by American band Mudhoney. The band by the Swedish band Mandu Diao. I've got a belly full of ouzo, and a head full of hurt. I took you down on ouzo, and now I think I'd rather see you dead.